And Brother Afshin was a radical Muslim. He read the Quran many, many times, once every 11 days or so. He was deep. He prayed more than anyone else. He was truly wanted to please Allah. Demons came into his prison. He heard a voice that said, just call the name of Jesus. He called Jesus. Demons left. Then Jesus appeared to him. He felt the holiness of Jesus. He said he was sorry. Jesus forgave him so easily. He just touched him and said, I forgive
you. So who are you that can forgive me and I feel forgiven today? And says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. The moment I heard those words, I knew it's of a great importance, but I had absolutely no idea what that meant. I still had no clue who this God is. So I asked him, what is your name? Jesus Christ, the living God, he answered. And the moment he spoke those words, it was as if every single bone was taken out of my body and I just fell on my face to the ground and I started weeping in the presence of God.
I love it so much. I want to invite right now my friend Afshin. Afshin, welcome. It's so good to see you. I know you're just touched by that story because it's so real to you. It's what happened to you. And I can see you're moved by God. I'm so happy to be with you. Wow, welcome. Welcome to the program, Face to Face with Jesus.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It's good to be with you guys.
Well, what's happening to you right now? Why are you so moved?
I'm just, thinking of that one moment with him. That changes everything. David says, one day in your courts is better than a thousand anywhere else. One glance of his eyes, one word out of his mouth. Jesus says, man does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes out of his mouth. And we don't really understand it till we have an experience. Moses knew his sight, but that moment on the mountain, Lord, changed everything for him.
What was the presence feel like when he was near you? I know there was a level of judgment, but did you feel a level of warmth? Like, can you feel that he always loved you? What did you feel like? Take us into that moment. We're all Jesus lovers, and we want to know as much as you can share about Jesus, his appearance, and what you experienced.
There is a smile on his face that it's like he's looking at something else. Or he's looking at someone else. Because you know that smile could not be for you, but you know it is for you. You know it could not be for you because you don't deserve to smile at you, because Jesus smiles and says, I'm pleased with you. I love you. And you are saying, how can that be? His smile is the smile of a lover that has longed to see you and hold you and embrace you. And it's the smile of a father that welcomes a son home or a daughter home. And it's the most strangest thing, because for 30 years I've spoken to Muslims, every single Muslim, every single Muslim that has had a dream or a vision, they remember his smile. And every single Muslim says, he had this peaceful face with a smile. Now in my experience, his eyes, the way he looked at me, He made me feel like I belonged to him. I always was his. And I have been away. And I couldn't understand how can you meet somebody for the first time, but your whole being says that you're actually coming home, that you actually were his. So, I explained about his eyes, and they said, what color is his eyes? And I've said it again and again that his eyes is like the ocean that has no bottom, no end to it. And this ocean, the water in this ocean is made out of love, kindness, peace, joy, everything that is absolutely good. And when he looks at you, his eyes takes you and puts you in right in the middle of that ocean, if you can ever figure out where that middle is. And the waves of this ocean do not go to shores, but from every shore, it comes towards you and it softly brushes against you. And every time it hits you, you feel loved, you feel kindness, you feel goodness, you feel mercies that are new every morning. And you know to this love, there is no end. And there is no power in heaven or on earth, in past, present, or future, that can separate you from that love.
I can just picture Jesus. Yes. I'm sorry. Go.
The color of his eyes.
Hallelujah. I can just picture him smiling right now and just watching us talking and being happy and loving listening to you talk about him. Hallelujah. What do you think Jesus, how do you think he feels about the Muslim people around the world who don't believe in him yet?
Doesn't really make a difference if you're Muslim, atheist, Hindu, Buddhist, whoever. He has already made his mind up about people. He knows every one of them by name. He has already made up his mind that he is in love with every one of them. It doesn't matter how you reject him and how often we have rejected him or how often we have questioned him. It doesn't matter even if we are Christian and we have rejected him. With our actions, our decisions, he has made up his mind that he's always, always, always gonna love you. And it's up to you if you wanna receive it, wanna believe it. Yeah, if you're a Muslim, of course, being from a Muslim background, I would love my brothers and sisters to know that when they pray, they don't need to hope Allah will accept their prayer. They don't need to wait till the day of judgment to know Allah will forgive them. They don't need to strive again and again and never hear the words of Allah that says, I love you, because Allah cannot say, I love you, because he has never. I mean, Quran is the most important book to all Muslims. And the most important words of Allah is written in the Quran. And everything that is written speaks about his desires, Allah's desires, and what Allah sees to be priority. And not once is it written in the Quran that Allah loves the people. So loving people is not a priority to Allah. That's the fact of Islam. That's the fact of Quran. And no Muslim in the world can deny that. But the very basic need of a human being is to feel loved. How can a God who has created us and who knows us more than anyone else knows that we long to be loved, not mention once that he loves his creation? That is why I believe Allah is not the God that created us. Because if he had created us, he would have loved us, and he would have, like the Bible mentioned 710 times, more than 710 times through and through Bible is written that God loves us. What? The first thing God wants to say to you is, I love you. And I have a verse for it in my word.
I still can't, this 18 years have gone by, but I still can't forget his love, his mercy. All the, forget what is for me that day. And he just forgive you. I felt forgiven. I fell on my face. I just wept because for many years I had tried to please God. But that wasn't, nothing I had done was pleasing to God. Nothing I had done. It wasn't even the bright God that I had known. I felt so deceived because they told me this is God and he wasn't God. They told me, "Qutilu fi sabilillah," kill in the way of Allah. But then, if God says love in the way of me, forgive in the way of me, and it was everything, my heart. Yes, this is the truth of God. God is about forgiveness. God is about love. So I wept for 2 hours. And I just stood at his feet. And he just said, I should look up. And the moment I looked up, I saw this. It was like a TV screen of some sort. I just saw people from all different generations and all different nationalities. And he says, Afshin, how easy did I forgive you? And I said, very easy. In Farsi, we say, as easy as drinking water. And then just moments after that, I said, no, even easier than drinking water. He says, as easy as I have forgiven you, I can forgive them. Who is going to tell them? I said, send me one. He says, go. So I prayed, God, send me a Bible. In jail, somebody from some other section just walked up to me and gave me a book and says, this is what you asked for. And he was in East Indian background, and I spoke Urdu and Hindi completely. So when he gave it to me, I knew it is the Bible. I forgot to thank you, God. I said, God, I prayed last night and you gave it to me this morning. It is so wonderful. Your answer, you are the mighty God that is spoken of, and you provide so quickly. That is the living word of God. I tell you this. I share my testimony so people hear about this Almighty God. I don't expect anybody to become a Christian because of my testimony. My testimony is only good for me. I want people to understand this. It is all able, and that is searching for all seeking hearts, that loves all humanity with all his strength and power. If someone hears my testimony today, I really like them to just say, okay, God of heaven, the creator of everything, if this is true, I want that. And I assure you, I can guarantee you that mighty God that came and touched and changed my life and totally forgive everything I have done. And he made me sure that I can be in heaven with him. He can assure them of the same assurance, and he can let them taste of the same forgiveness and same love.
So every morning when you get up, Steve, or whoever you are, the first thing God wants to say to you is, I love you. And I have a verse for it in my word. And every evening, he wants to say, I love you again. Whether you had a tough day or a good day, whether you forgot about him or remembered him all through and through, whether you made bad decisions or good decisions, every single day, morning and evening, he will encounter you with a different word that expresses his love for you in a unique way. That he really knew that our need is love, and he knew that greater than the food we eat and the clothes we wear and the money we put in our pocket, we need to know we are loved. So he said, for God so loved the world. For God so loved the world. Not just loved the world. For God so loved the world.
The message of Jesus and the Messiah, and the one who's come to forgive us and to die on the cross. Throughout the Old Testament, the prophet said the Messiah must come and he must die for us. He must die for the sins of humanity. Moses, disciple of Jesus, he would never betray Jesus. He said with all certainty, all these things are written for two reasons, that you may know Jesus is the Son of God, and that by believing in him, you may have life in his name. But those two things are the worst two things to reject, because before the Quran was written, all the prophets, Moses, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, all of them were saying a different message, including Jesus. He said, no one takes my life away. I'm going to give it willingly. He says, the Son of Man must be given into the hands of sinful men, be crucified, and on the third day, raise again. Jesus himself said he must be crucified. If you're Muslim right now, I love you. I know that this is strange right now, what you're hearing. You're hearing the story of a man who radically had encountered God, who radically is living for God right now. We haven't even begun to explain what he does now and how he serves God every single day, helping poor people. We haven't even begun. But you know something in your heart, because the Bible says no one could come to God unless God draws them by his Spirit. So if you're watching today, you know that the man that has spoken today has encountered something very special. He has peace in his life. He's not making up a story. He's not asking for anything. He's just saying, I've received forgiveness. I have a relationship with God. If you want to have a relationship with God, you really want to meet him as a father, as one who loves you, and you really want to follow the ways of Jesus, who says, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. If you want to have this opportunity, I believe God is giving you that opportunity right now to receive him. Just close your eyes and repeat this prayer with me and just say, Father God, I need you. I believe that Jesus died on the cross for me. I believe that Jesus rose again from the dead. Jesus, repeat with me this prayer. Jesus, save me. Forgive me. Forgive me. Forgive me. Come into my heart. I receive you as my Savior and my Lord. Amen. If you prayed this prayer, I believe the Lord heard you, because the Bible says, whoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Wherever you are right now, you know Jesus. The name of Jesus is only the beginning of it. He says, I am the door. Why? Because through Jesus, the doors of opportunities are open to you. Some people park it at the door. Now I know Jesus, that's it, I'll be saved. Man, that's only the beginning. Jesus will open a whole new world to you. He will make your life more beautiful, more marvelous. You don't need to look in the history book for someone that changed the world. You will become the world changer. Wow. You will become the one that everyone will talk about. If you are just a lover of Jesus and an obedient servant, that's it. Counting the moment to meet him, to be with him. And what I would say to him is, thank you for giving me a life that was not so self-centered. Thank you for giving me a life that I could experience so many different people with different backgrounds and different experiences. And I was able to just bring them home. To hear them when they were weeping, to hold me. Thank you for every time you gave me a chance to bring food for those who are hungry. Thank you for every moment of every day. Because Jesus, if you hadn't come into my life, I would have literally wasted every moment of it. I wouldn't have been able to love so many and be loved by so many.
Thank you so much for taking time to share these beautiful words. We know that you're a genuine person. I think it doesn't take a rocket scientist to see that. And I'm very grateful for you. You've blessed my life. And until next time, well, peace of Jesus be upon you. I love you. I love you. Salaam alaikum.
All right, take the same faith, put it in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and you will know who Jesus is. You accept him by faith, and he comes into your life and into your heart, and you know that he's who he claims to be. Now, some of you can ridicule, some of you can reject him. Some can just put it off and say, I'm going to wait till another time. Or you can accept it as your Lord and your Savior and your Master and the Son of God. And he will come into your heart and forgive your sin and change your life.